writer came from Edinburgh. This sign is very known as one is human. This immigrant form changed to Chinese character like this. This plane immigrant changed to Chinese character like this. In China, Chinese people use a lot of Chinese names. Among them, I choose two. One is traditional Chinese and one is modern Chinese. What's the difference between traditional Chinese and modern? In traditional Chinese, to become a one character, we have to write so many steps. So, very difficult to learn Chinese language. So they are decide how to be easy to learn Chinese language. So they are start creating the modern Chinese. So they reduce the Chinese step how to write the Chinese character. So foreigner want to learn Chinese language. It's very easy to learn and it's very easy to recognize because of less than. This one called Mandarin. The official national standard spoken language of China, which is based on the principal dialect spoken in and around Beijing. Also called Huoyu Putonghua. In this table, the white color would be like this one or the combined consonant and vowel. The balance of they didn't combine, so you need to pronounce. So you know this table, writing in, showing this white color one only, you have to pronounce. If you can pronounce very well in this table, you can speak Chinese very well. In this table, have as you see some white color word we are writing, then have we cannot say whether each word must have exact meaning or not. So some may be one word have meaning, some may not be meaning. If we combine two words in Chinese language, we can get another one more meaning. That means if this N is consonant, I is vowel, so they combine one word. Remember, they have this one is third song. So, ni, hao, Chinese character, ni hao. So this Li is you, how Li root, but they combine Li Hao Li, how you do. So you can get some. This one, Zai Jian. Zai is again. Jian is meat. So again, meat, so that meat is seen again. So sometimes Chinese, every word have meaning, sometimes don't have meaning. The Chinese language, the weakness is they cannot create new word a lot. So they are using repeat and repeat. So it can be confused. So we have to learn Chinese language. Be careful their weakness. Then you can get more language. Every language have their own grammar rules. Among them, I choose a statement and question only. 你好，好久不见. Question 你好吗? In Chinese, question is very easy. If you want to ask. You want to make your statement to become a question, you can put ma. You don't need to know too much. So, 你好吗? That one is the treat na. This na have, they have their own question meaning. So you can add like a statement that you can put a question mark to become a question. The church marks. This shaman is a question type. So you no need to, in Chinese language, grammar don't have a lot compared with English language. So very easy to understand their grammar. You want to learn Chinese language, you must know and study Pinyin theorem. Just now, Pinyin theorem is the most important to learn Chinese language. You are not able to pronounce in Chinese language without using this theorem. So if you pronounce very well in this theorem, you will need to ask anybody how to pronounce this word. Because you can pronounce yourself, so you can study yourself, you can learn yourself. If you know at least 1,000 more Chinese words, you can speak very well in daily uses. Then you have to decide yourself. You want to learn speaking only, so you can learn Pinyin only. If you want to learn writing also, so you can learn their character and you must memorize what is the definition. So I hope this one the basics of the Chinese language. If before you learn Chinese language, you understand more Chinese character, why the Pinyin and why we are international language, because people want to learn easily, then only they want to promote their language. Thanks for giving me.